Hello viewers, it's my pleasure to welcome you all for learning the civil engineering concepts. Hello viewers, in this video I will discuss about the fundamental concepts of design of footings. The outline of this presentation is, from this video you will learn what is the purpose of providing the footing, what are the different types of footing, what are the design assumptions wherein the footing, what are the requirements for design of the foundations. Finally, we will learn about the what are the different failure modes of the footing, how it will governs the design. First, we will see what is the purpose of the footing. The purpose of the footing is, it has to transmit the load coming from the structure supported by the columns or walls to the soil without the risk of failure of the soil. The function is simply transfer the load coming from the structure through the column to the soil without the failure of the next. The part of the structure provided above the ground level is called superstructure. Below the ground level is called substructure. Foundation is a part of the substructure. We have to know the difference between the foundation and the footing. Foundation is a part of the structure which is directly in contact with the soil to transfer the load to the soil. Footing is used to transfer the vertical load, horizontal load, moment and whatever forces acting from the column can be transferred to the soil through the footing. This footing can be generally classified into two types. First one is isolated footing, second one is combined footing. Isolated footing means, if a footing is provided for only one column, means that is called as isolated footing. Based on the shape of the footing in the plan, it is further classified into three types: square footing, rectangular footing, circular footing. These are the shape of the footing in plan. Next one is pile footing. This can be used to transfer the load by end bearing or by friction. Single pile can be used to transfer the load coming from the single column, or a group of piles can be used to transfer the load coming from the single column to the soil. That depends upon the pile capacity and properties of the soil. Then what is meant by combined footing. If a footing is provided for two or more number of columns, means that can be called as combined footing. Among these five types, here, first one is rectangular combined footing. If the plan shape is rectangular, means that is a rectangular combined footing, this is used to connect the two columns. Trapezoidal footing also used to connect the two columns. Strap footing is also used to connect the two columns. These three footings are used to connect the two columns. Trapezoidal footing is in the shape of trapezoidal in the plan. Okay, strap footing, where we can use the strap footing? Suppose we are providing the column at the boundary line itself, means we cannot extend the footing beyond the boundary line. We cannot extend to the adjoining boundary. Okay, in that case we have to connect the boundary column with the interior column by connecting a beam. That beam is called the strap beam. Then strip footing. If we provide a footing, common footing for two or more number of columns in a row. Two or more number of columns in a row means that is called a strip footing. Next one is mat or wrap foundation. This type of footing can be used when the SBC of the soil is very low, the load coming from the column is very heavy, and also a danger of differential settlement, means we have to go for a mat or wrap foundation. Let me show the some of the figures of these footings for easy understanding. Okay? This one is a square footing. See, the shape is square in the plan. This is also a square footing, but it is having uniform thickness it is having a varying thickness. We have provided more thickness near the column face, less thickness at the edge. Coming to the pile foundation, here I have provided a 4 number of piles to support a column strip footing. It will connect a columns in a one row. Here I have used 3 number of columns. Coming to the combined rectangular footing, here we have a 2 columns that are connected by a single footing which is in rectangular of shape. We seen from the top, you are able to see like this. This is the plan of the footing. This is the longitudinal sectional view. Shows the 2 columns with the footing having uniform thickness. Then trapezoidal combined footing. Here also we are having 2 columns, okay, which are connected by using a slab of uniform thickness, but it is trapezoidal in shape. In the plan, this is a longitudinal sectional view. And coming to the strap footing, see, this column is provided at the boundary of the column. We cannot extend this footing beyond this boundary line. So to avoid the eccentricity and all, we are connecting this column with the interior column through a beam. That beam is called strap beam. Here we are having the same thickness of the strap beam with the footing. Sometimes this thickness may be little higher than the thickness of the footing. Next one is raft or mat foundation. Here the footing is provided for a group of columns. The behavior of the footing is act like a inverted beam slab construction or flat slab construction. See the roof slab. The roof slab is supported by the beam. Beam is supported by the column. In that case, we have a dead load. Dead load was due to self weight of the slab and also finishing load, then live load. Now I have inverted that system. In this case, we are having a slab at the bottom, then beam, then columns. The load acting on this one is upward soil pressure. See, here they have provided only one single slab. Here they have provided with the slab and beam system as like our conventional beam column system. If we use a single slab and all means there is an, we need to provide more thickness. To avoid that, they are using the slab and beam construction. I will give one example to understand where we are using the raft foundation. We can, if you consider a lift room construction, they will provide columns at the 4 corners. If you provide a footing, they will overlap each other. They will join all the footings as a single common footing. Okay? That is a good example for raft or mat. Okay? Now this is a quiz time. The question for you is, which of the following is not an isolated footing? You have 4 choices. Go through the answers. Press pause button. Think over the answers and play. Pause now. Option is C. Because sloped footing is isolated footing. Circular footing also isolated footing. Pile also isolated footing. Strap footing is provided for 2 columns. Next you will see that what are the design assumptions of the footing. The design of the footing is based on the assumption that the foundation is considered as rigid. The variation of pressure under the foundation will be linear. These are the very important 2 assumptions they have made to design any foundation. First one is the footing is considered as rigid. The variation of pressure under the footing is linear. Let us see how it is. See, here I am having a footing. This is the column having an axial load. According to this assumption, the pressure distribution below the footing is uniform. The pressure is obtained by load by area. Simply load by area. If you coming to the actual cases, this is a pressure distribution of the pressure distribution below the footing for the soil in flexible footing on cohesionless soil. This pressure distribution is for flexible footing on cohesive soil. This pressure distribution is for rigid footing on cohesive soil. This pressure distribution is for rigid footing on cohesionless soil. These footings are having all are curved one. We are considering the linear one in our assumption. Whether it is correct or wrong, how it is, you have to think about it. Let me draw the considered linear pressure distribution. Similarly for these cases also. See, sir, you have drawn a red line, uniform pressure distribution. Here, you have missed something. Here, you have omitted something. Here, you have added something. This is the questions occur in your mind. Okay, to make it as a life symbol, they have made the pressure distribution as linear. For curved and all means very difficult to calculate the pressure. See, here also, what we have done, this is the original pressure distribution. We have taken little higher, here little lower. Finally, I am adding something and subtracting something. Finally, it will tally. That is the assumption. The next one condition is, the distribution of the pressure will be uniform if the centroid of the footing coincide with the resultant of the applied load. The footing will have an upward soil pressure. That centroid of the footing should coincide with the load is acting through the center of the column. So I will show that with through the diagram. Suppose this is our footing. The footing has a CG, centroid is here. It is having upward soil pressure. Then you can consider the column. The column center is somewhere here. If we coincide the center of this column with the center of this footing, by providing like this, means what will happen? We are coinciding the centroid of the footing with the CG of the column load. So in that case, footing will be subjected to uniform pressure distribution. Suppose if you are not matching this, means what will happen? You will have a eccentricity. How it will be there? See, I'll draw a, this is footing, for example. Okay. This center is here, but I am providing a column here. If this center is here, what happened? There is some distance in between them, that is called eccentricity. Due to this eccentricity, there is a bending will happen in the footing. The pressure distribution is not linear, it is linearly varying. If it coincides, means the pressure distribution will be uniform. These assumptions are hold good only in rigid foundation. Almost all RCC structures are rigid foundations. These assumptions become less accurate in relatively more flexible footing. If you are using a footing like a grillage foundation, all means it will be flexible in case. For that case, you have to refer some specialized literature. Your queries and suggestions are welcome.